Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about module number 1, that is introduction to power system protection. Here we are going to discuss about merits and demerits of relays. Today we are going to discuss about merits and demerits of relays. So let us discuss about that the merits of static relays over electromechanical relays. So if you see that merits of static relays over electromechanical relays, which are follows as, the first one is like low burden on current transformers and voltage transformers. When we go through that static relays, because static relays does not put much burden like current stress and voltage stress on the current transformers and voltage transformers, the static relays consumes less power. In most of the cases, they draw power from the auxiliary DC supply, because in order to function the static relay, it consumes very less power. That to function that static relay, it required an additional DC power supply, which we are giving with an auxiliary DC power supply at here. And that too, this static relays will give fast response, because the static relays devices like diodes, transistors, ICs, SCRs, comparators and other SCR family device having fast response, because whose switching frequency is very high, that's why it gives that very fast response. And that too, these devices will give us long life, that means it gives high reliability. And that too, the static relays have high resistance to shock and vibration, so it can withstand for high short circuit currents and for high vibrations. Whenever a lightning strokes takes place, by that time high current which is appear or which is flowing through the transmission line, so these static relays are going to withstand from high or a short circuits or when from a electric shocks and from the vibrations, and less maintenance due to the absence of moving parts and bearings. For suppose if we see a machine which consists of armature winding and field winding, or stator and rotor like AC machines and DC machines, which are the moving parts, and bearings also is there for the motor, that's why it requires a high maintenance. But coming to that static relay, it does not have any rotating part or any movable part like a circuit breaker, how it will be trip off and trip on it, like to open the circuit breaker and to close the circuit breaker of the switch. That kind of opening and closing of the switch is not required here, because we are using that relays are static relays which are related to static switches like SCR family devices, so it doesn't require any moving parts. It does not have any moving parts and bearings, therefore it has a less maintenance compared to the electromechanical relays. And next one is, frequent operations cause no deterioration. Even though a short circuit fault which was happened repeatedly with a fraction of seconds, with respect to that fault, these static relays are going to make the circuit and break the circuit. It is going to bypass or it is going to isolate that faulty section of the system and healthy section of the system. So there is no any cause for deterioration, even though frequently the operation has been takes place at here. And one more advantage is quick resetting and absence of overshoot. That means once the fault is cleared, then automatically it make as a short circuit. once if the fault is not cleared, automatically it can make as a open circuit. So once the fault is cleared, automatically it is going to reclose that circuit breaker switch. I mean, it act as a short circuit for absence of overshoot also, and that too solid state, solid type static relays are very compact in size, whose size is small and it is very comfortable to operate, and it gives greater sensitivity as amplification can be provided easily for fault currents and for fault voltage, like short circuit currents and open circuit voltages. And one more advantage is, like, it is a complex relaying characteristics can easily be obtained. So the complex relaying characteristics like line current, line voltage, line phase angle with respect to that line voltage and current, this kind of information we are going to obtain very easily when we are go through that static relays compared to that electromechanical relays. And that too it is used for logic circuits for complex protective schemes. So because of the presence of complex protective schemes, even it is used for logic circuits where the logic is executed very easily, and therefore we are going to provide that protection against overcurrents and over voltages. Thereby we are going to protect that circuit devices, and thereby we are going to give that continuity of electrical power supply without having any interruptions. Then the logic circuit may take decisions to operate under certain conditions and not to operate under other conditions. So that means the device has to perform the operation whenever a short circuit condition has been takes place, or whenever a fault event takes place, or whenever a fault voltage or fault current has been recorded on the transmission line. Unnecessarily it won't perform any operation. Even though if it performs that operations, it is going to isolate that healthy section of the system, not only that faulty section of the system. So these are the some of the things what we are going to take into account while we are going to perform the operation. That is, like, to trip off the circuit breaker, to trip on the circuit breaker. Whenever we are going to trip off the circuit breaker or trip on the circuit breaker has to receive that right commanding signal from the right protective device which was employing in that particular zone. So like this, here we are going to use the logic circuits which may take the decision under certain conditions, especially to protect the circuit systems or the total entire load. Now let us see that disadvantages or demerits of static relays. Static relays are temperature sensitive. There are two types of temperatures are there. One is positive temperature quotient, one is negative temperature quotient. With respect to positive temperature quotient, if the temperature of the device is increases, then the device resistance will increases. Then it leads to that positive temperature quotient. Then negative temperature quotient, with respect to the rise of temperature, there is a decreasing that value of the resistance which causes to damage. So wherever there exists that positive temperature quotient, negative temperature quotient, if you see that characteristics of that particular device with respect to current and voltage, with respect to current and voltage, if you see that particular characteristics, it doesn't possess any linear characteristics between the XY plane, like a straight line which is not passing through the origin, for wherever there is a temperature sensitive devices. So if a static relay is a temperature sensitive device, then their characteristics may vary and it is not linear, and there is a variation of temperature, and temperature compensation can be made by using thermistors. Thermistors are temperature compensating devices, like heat sink devices which extract that heat from the device to outside. So if I want to use again thermistors, it costs to lead additional cost to that equipment. So it is one of the disadvantages. By using digital techniques for measurements, etc., where we are going to provide the additional cost. The second demerit is static relays are sensitive to voltage transients and the semiconductor components may get damaged due to voltage spikes, because if more voltage will come just for a fraction of a second, sometimes the static relays may get damaged. So in order to protect that static relays like from voltage transients and from voltage spikes or power surges, we have to use filters and proper shielding to protect against voltage spikes. And also that static relays need an auxiliary power supply, extra power supply, additional resource is required, additional source is required. So it also comes under additional cost. This can, however, can be easily supplied by a battery or a stabilized power supply, but includes that cost. So these are the three demerits which includes like static relay. Thank you.